Music in this game is stored in binary wave or bwave files. These files can be found in the sound directory of the game's ROMFS, which you've hopefully dumped before. This video will go over how to mod custom music into the game, and how to extract audio from a bwave to a normal wave. If the song you want to replace already exists in another game, like New Leaf, then you can go to smashcustommusic.net. It provides pre-made files and bwaves to import into other games. If your song can't be found, however, you'll have to create your own. You can do this two ways: Open Revolution or Sister Composer with the Looping Audio Converter. Open Revolution is a command line app and works on Windows, Arch Linux, and Mac. Sister Composer and Looping Audio Converter are GUI apps who work on Windows only. This video will be going over both, using Sister Composer and Looping Audio Converter first. If you're on Linux or Mac, or prefer the command line, then skip to this time on screen. Download Looping Audio Converter from this link. You'll also need to download Audacity from this link. The last thing you need is Sister Composer. Go to this link on screen and download the Sister Composer installer. Follow the default settings throughout the installation. Now, extract a zip of the Looping Audio Converter and open the app. Add your song to the list at the top. If you want to convert multiple songs, then you can add them the same way. Change the output format to BCSTM, and then hit Start. If you're replacing a KK Slider song, check Convert to Mono before clicking Start. All songs will be in the output folder of Looping Audio Converter. Open a folder, then double-click on a file, and it should play in Sister Composer. Expand the channel section and make sure you have the right amount of channels. Some songs in the game have loop points. This means that a portion of the song will be heard once, but when the song repeats, it will not be heard again. If your song loops normally from start to end, then you don't have to worry about this. But if it doesn't, you can use the green slider on the left and red slider on the right to make loop points for you. The green segment is the beginning of the song that does not loop. It only plays once. The red slider is for the end of the song and at the end of the loop. If your song doesn't have a fade out or a silent period at the end, you shouldn't have to change this. You can also use Audacity to find a good loop. Change the time counter to display the sample number, then paste that into Sister Composer. If you know the exact second your song loops, then this should make the process easier.
With your loop point set, click on Project Info, then check the loop box.
Expand the window vertically, then click Update Project Info.
Afterwards, click File, Export Binary.
Make sure to have it named the same as in a game's ROMFS or the song will not load. Using the layered FS filter that you should have created, put your custom bwave into the same directory as in a ROMFS. For example, if you're replacing a bgm_title.bwave, then you'd place it in Sound, Resource, Stream of the layered FS. For extracting a track, go to Edit, Export Wave, and save it wherever you'd like. At this point, you can open it in your favorite music player. Now skip to this time on screen to patch your bars file, or continue watching if you're using Open Revolution. If you're on Windows, download Open Revolution here. If you're on Arch Linux, download it from the Arch user repository. If you're on Mac OS, install it with Homebrew through FreeApp2014/stuff. Open Revolution requires a wave as its input. If your song is not a wave already, download Audacity from this link. Download the version corresponding to your OS. When installed, drag the song to Audacity, then go to File, Export, Export as Wave. On Windows, extract a zip and copy the created WAV file into the same folder as Open Revolution. Now open a folder in the command prompt. This can be done by typing CMD inside the search bar. Now type the following command. If you're on Linux or Mac, open a terminal in the same location as the WAV file. Then, run the same command shown before, but without the .exe. Switch games that use BWAV files have information stored about them in a separate bars archive. When replacing a BWAV with your own custom music, you'll also need to replace the information about the BWAV in a bars file. This can be done with the automatic bars patcher. Download the NRO and place it in a Switch folder on your SD card. To use the automatic bars patcher, you'll need dumps of your ROMFS on a Switch. If you moved it to your PC and don't want to wait another 4 hours for it to dump, you don't have to. Just redump the sound directory, which is where the bars are. Open NX Dump Tool and go to New Horizons. In the ROMFS options of NH, select Browse ROMFS section. Open a sound folder and press Y to dump everything in that directory. With that done, exit NX Dump Tool by pressing the plus button. Now launch the automatic bars patcher. Press A to select ACNH and review the file path shown to you. Make sure they're correct, and if not, press B to edit them. Once everything's set, press A to accept and patch. Hopefully, it's a success, and if not, review the error message. It should tell you what went wrong. Now go home and launch Animal Crossing. You should hear the patched songs.
Thanks for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to see future modding tutorials. Leave a comment or join my Discord if you have an issue, and I'll do my best to respond. My website has this video and future ones that aren't in video form completed, so if you'd rather read something now instead of waiting for the video, go ahead.